गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माई चैनल डिजिटल जनरेशन। दिस चैनल इज रिगार्डिंग चैप्टर वाइज प्रिपरेशन फॉर बोथ ICSE एंड CBSE स्टूडेंट्स। आई होप यू विल गेट बेस्ट नॉलेज एंड एक्सप्लेनेशन फ्रॉम दिस चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट इलेक्ट्रिक पावर। द रेट ऑफ डूइंग वर्क इज कॉल्ड पावर। We will define electric power by using the term work as well as by using the term energy, because work and energy both has the same unit called joule. So electric power, when electric current flows through a conductor, we know that electric energy is being consumed and we say that electric work is done. So electric power is equal to electric work done per unit time, that is electric power is equal to work done by time taken, that is power P is equal to work done W by T. Now what will be the SI unit of power? SI unit of work is joule and time is second. So power will be joule per second, which is called watt, and watt is denoted by the word W. So 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per 1 second. So 1 watt is the power when 1 joule of work is done in time 1 second. Now watt is a very smaller unit, and for commercial purpose we use kilowatt. So 1 kilowatt will be equal to 1000 watt. Now we will define the term electric power by using the term energy. We know that when work is done, equal amount of energy is consumed. So we can say that electric power is equal to electric energy consumed per unit time. So we can say that electric power is equal to electric energy consumed per unit time, that is energy by time, that is joule per second. So when power is 1 watt and energy consumed is 1 joule in time 1 second, then we can say that the power of 1 watt means when 1 joule of electric energy is consumed in 1 second. So when we say that a bulb has a power of 60 watt, or we write in this way, 60 watt. So what does it mean? It means a bulb of 60 watt will consume electric energy of 60 joules per second. So now we can define the term electric power by using both electric work and electric energy. That is, electric power is the rate at which the electric work is done, or the rate at which the electric energy is consumed is known as electric power. Now we will calculate the formula for calculating electric power. We have studied that power is equal to work done by time taken. In our previous class, we have discussed that the potential difference between two points in a circuit, that is V, is equal to work done W by quantity of charge moved Q. Charge moved is denoted by what? Q. So we have seen that V is equal to W by Q, or W is equal to V into Q. Again, we have studied that the magnitude of current I equal to quantity of charge moved at a given point in a conductor in time 1 second, Q by T. I is equal to Q by T, that is Q is equal to I into T. We will put I into T in place of Q, that is W is equal to V into I into T. Now we will calculate power. Power, we have studied work done, W time taken, T. Now W we got V into I into T. V into I into T divided by T is equal to V into I. So what we got? We got power is equal to potential difference into current. That is, power is equal to voltage into current. So power consumed by any electrical appliance or power expended in any electrical appliance depends on the voltage on which it is applied and the current it draws from the circuit. That 1 watt is equal to 1 V into 1 ampere, or 1 watt is equal to 1 V into A. So we get another formula for the unit of power. So 1 watt of electrical power consumed by any electric device means that when it is operated at a voltage of 1 volt and the current carries by it is 1 ampere. This is the formula number 1. P is equal to V into I. Power is equal to voltage into current. Now formula number 2. Sometimes it what happens that voltage is not given, only current and resistance is given. Then what we do, instead of V, we put the value by calculating by Ohm's law. V is equal to, we know, I into R. According to Ohm's law, R is equal to V by I, or V is equal to I into R. That is V is equal to IR. Now in place of V, we will put I into R. That is power is equal to I into R into I. That is I squared into R. This is formula number 2. That is power is equal to I squared into R. This is the formula 2. Now in third formula, we will see that when current is not given, only when voltage and resistance is given, then we will find current according to Ohm's law is equal to V by R. Current, we know that R is equal to V by I. So I is equal to V by R. This is the Ohm's law. So I is equal to V by R. Now we will put V by R in place of I in formula number 1. So P is equal to V into, in place of I, we will put V by R. V by R. That is V squared by R. This is formula number 3. So the formula power is V squared by R. Formula number 1 states P is equal to V into I. Formula number 2 states P is equal to I squared R. And formula number 3 states P is equal to V squared by R. From this, it is very clear that power is inversely proportional to resistance. P is equal to V squared R. So power is inversely proportional to resistance. So when power is more in any electrical appliance, then in that electrical appliance, resistance will be less. And when power is less, then resistance will be more. So if we take two bulbs of 60 watt and 100 watt, it is often asked that why 60 watt bulb is dimmer than 100 watt bulb, or why 100 watt bulb glows more brightly than 60 watt bulb. Because in 60 watt bulb and 100 watt bulb, the power is less in 60 watt bulb. So resistance is more here in 60 watt bulb, and in there in 100 watt bulb, power is more, 100 watt more than 60 watt. So power is more and hence resistance is less. Thus 60 watt bulbs glows dimmer or 100 watt bulb glows more brightly when these two bulbs of 60 watt and 100 watt is taken. Thus in 60 watt bulb power is less, so resistance is more, so it glows dimmer. And in case of 100 watt bulb, power is more, so resistance is less, so it glows brightly. Now we will calculate the power voltage rating of electrical appliance. We have seen that power P is equal to voltage V into current I. Every electrical appliance has a level or a plate engraved on it which states the potential difference on which it is to be applied and the power consumed by that electrical device. Suppose we take a bulb 100 watt 220 volt. It means that the power consumed by that bulb is 100 watt and the voltage on which it is to be applied or on which it is operated is 220 volt. And power rating of 100 watt means it will consume electric energy of 100 joule per second. So 100 watt bulb means that the power consumed or energy consumed by that electric bulb is 100 joule per second and the voltage on which it is to be applied is 220 volt. By using this formula, we can calculate the current it will draw from the circuit when power and voltage is known. R will be equal to P by V. So if R bulb has a 40 watt power, then what will be the current drawn by it? we can calculate I is equal to P by V, power is equal to 40 watt and V is equal to 220 volt. In our domestic line, we have 220 volt. So, in case of tube light or any other electric appliance, the voltage is always 220 volt. So, current of 0.18 ampere. So, the current drawn by a tube light of 40 watt will be 0.18 ampere. Again, if our power is given, suppose 60 watt, then what will be the current drawn by it? Voltage, we know that 220 volt. So again, current will be power 60 by 220 volt is equal to 0.27 ampere. Thus, the current drawn by 60 watt bulb will be 0.27 ampere. Again, we can say that 100 watt bulb operating on 220 volt will draw a current is equal to P by V is equal to 100 divided by 220 is equal to 0.45 ampere. Thus, we can see that current drawn by any electrical device can be calculated by knowing the power and voltage. So, every electrical appliance has a power voltage rating given on it. Now, we will take an example to be more clear. This is a numerical problem. A bulb of 100 watt is operated on 220 volt. How much power will be consumed by that bulb if it is operated on 110 volt? In first case, power was 100 watt and voltage was 220. In second case, voltage was given 110 volt. What is the power consumed? So in this case, we have seen that current is not given. We will use formula number 3, that is V squared by R. In first case, we will find R. P is given 100 watt and V is given 220 into 220 divided by R, or R will be equal to 220 divided by 100 is equal to 484 ohm. So the resistance in first case is 484 ohm, and this resistance will not change. It will remain same in case when it is operated on 110 volt. Second case, what happens? Voltage V is equal to given 110 volt and resistance we have calculated, which remains unchanged, is 484 ohm. Thus, power we will calculate again. P is equal to V squared by R by using the formula number 3. So, P is equal to, voltage is here is 110 into 110 divided by R is equal to 484 is equal to 25 watt. So, the power in case when it is operated on 110 volt, then it will be 25 watt. Now, we will calculate the formula for calculating electric energy. We have seen that electric power is equal to work done by electric current by time taken. And according to the law of conservation of mass, we know electric work done will be equal to the electric energy consumed. So we can write that electric power is equal to electric energy consumed by time taken. Thus, electric energy is equal to power into time. So, electric energy consumed by any electrical device depends on two factors: the power rating of that electrical device and the time of which it is used. Now, is equal to P into T. So, electrical energy consumed by any electric device depends on two factors: the power rating of that electrical appliance and the time of which it is used. Let's find the unit. P is equal to watt and time is equal to hour. So, electric energy is equal to watt hour when it is 1 watt and time is equal to 1 hour, then electric energy will be 1 watt hour. So, electric energy of 1 watt hour will be consumed by an electrical appliance when the power of that electrical device is 1 watt and it is used for 1 hour. But this watt hour is a very small unit. We have a commercial unit of kilowatt hour. Find the commercial unit of electrical energy. The SI unit of electrical energy is joule. So 1 joule of electrical energy consumed by any electrical device means the power rating of that electrical device is 1 watt and is used for 1 second. So 1 joule is equal to 1 watt into 1 second. So it is a very small unit. So for commercial purpose we use larger unit. Instead of joule we use kilowatt hour. So 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1 kilowatt into 1 hour. So 1 kilowatt hour of electric energy consumed by any electrical device means when the power rating of that electrical device is 1 kilowatt and is used for 1 hour. Again we know that 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watt. So electrical energy of 1 kilowatt hour will be consumed by an electrical appliance when the power rating is 1000 watt and it is used for 1 hour. One thing must be remembered that the unit of power is watt and kilowatt, but the unit of electric energy is watt hour or kilowatt hour, but the SI unit of electrical energy is joule. Now we will find the relationship between SI unit and commercial unit. We have studied that SI unit of electrical energy is joule. Commercial unit of electric energy is kilowatt hour. Now we will find the relationship between this kilowatt hour and joule. We know 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1 kilowatt of power into 1 hour. Got it? 1 kilowatt means 1000 watt into 1 hour. We are calculating 1 kilowatt hour of energy. This is the commercial unit of energy. Now we know that 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per 1 second. So 1000 watt will be equal to 1000 joule per second. So we will put this value. 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1000 into joule per second. And 1 hour means 60 into 60 second is equal to 36 lakh joules, or we write 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joule. Thus 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joules. This relationship is very important and we are often asked to convert kilowatt hour into joule. So remember, 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joule. This is very important formula. 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joules. Now we will go through some numerical problems. E is equal to P into T, that is electrical energy used is equal to power into time. Number 1, when 60 watt radio is used for 50 hours, then calculate the electric energy consumed by this radio. Here power is 60 watt, or 60 by 1000 is equal to 0.06 kilowatt, and electric energy is equal to, we know, P into T, power is equal to 0.06 into hour is equal to 50 hour is equal to 3 kilowatt hour. So the electrical energy consumed by the radio of 60 watt is 3 kilowatt hour. This is asked to convert it into joules, then we know that 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joule. So 3 kilowatt hour is equal to 3 into 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joule will be equal to 10.8 into 10 to the power 6 joule. So 10.8 into 10 to the power 6 joules of energy will be consumed by a radio of 60 watt. Now second problem, if 4 ampere of current flows through a car headlight lamp of 12 volt for 10 minutes, then find the electrical energy consumed by the car headlight lamp. Here current I is given 4 ampere and voltage V is given 12 volt. So we will calculate power. P is equal to V into I, V is equal to 12 and current is equal to 4 is equal to 48 watt. Thus power is equal to 48 watt, or 48 by 1000 is equal to 0.048 kilowatt. This is the power. Now we have to find the electrical energy consumed when it is used for 10 minutes. 10 minute means 10 by 60 hour, that is 1 by 6 hour. Now we will calculate electrical energy is equal to P into T. We have calculated 0.048 and time is equal to 1 by 6 hour is equal to 0.008 kilowatt hour. Thus the electric energy consumed by the car headlight lamp of 12 volt is 0.008 kilowatt hour. This is the electrical energy consumed by it if it is used for 10 minutes. Now the third word problem, if a current of 5 ampere flows through a resistance of 2 ohm for 30 minutes, then find the energy transmission that takes place. Here current is given 5 ampere, resistance is equal to 2 ohm. So we will calculate power by using the formula I squared R, that is 5 into 5 into 2. R is 2 given 2 ohm. 25 into 2 is equal to 50 watt. So what is the electrical power here? 50 watt. Now we will calculate 50 watt into kilowatt by dividing it by 1000 is equal to 0.05 kilowatt. This is the power. Now time is given 30 minute. 30 minute means 30 by 60 is equal to half hour, means 0.5 hour. Now we will calculate electric energy. The formula of electric energy is E is equal to P into T. Power we have calculated 0.05 and time is equal to 0.5 equal to 0.025 kilowatt hour. This is the electrical energy consumed when 5 ampere of current flows through a resistor of 2 ohm for 30 minutes. Now if it is asked that calculate or convert this electrical energy into joule, then you will multiply this 0.025 kilowatt hour into 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joule, and you will get 0.009 into 10 to the power 6 joule. In my next video, I will teach you about the cost of calculating the electric energy consumed in our domestic line. Thank you for watching my video, and if you find my video useful, please do like, share and subscribe my channel. And if you have any doubt regarding this chapter, please comment below. I will try to answer as early as possible.